You need to be authentic. You need to be genuine. As a coach, it is imperative that your integrity is held at the highest standard for yourself. Hi everyone, it's Tina with Picture It Personal Finance, where I ask you to picture your goal, plan to achieve it, and enjoy success. As you can tell from today's video title, I will be explaining why I decided not to become a Ramsey Preferred Coach. When I provided my FCMT review video, one of the most frequent questions that I received, both in the comment sections and then individually through people reaching out via email, was whether or not I was doing the Ramsey Preferred Coaching or the Ramsey Preferred Coach Referral Program, and what I thought about it, what I thought were included in that, and the costs related to it. At the time that I graduated FCMT, that program was advertised to us to be $49 per month. Now, I was still working corporate at the time, and it was not a good fit. After I left corporate, I looked at it again, and I looked at it really closely, and it had gone up to $149 per month. That is over $100. I'm sorry, that is right at a $100 increase from the fees for just a year earlier. This floored me, and it put a lot of fear in me that if they could increase the fees that much in the matter of a year, then what might it look like in the future? Now, assuming that they're not going to increase the fees again, I was truly concerned about even paying that much as a monthly expense for a business that's just blossoming. I'm just getting started, and my monthly operating expenses, since I'm running this as a debt-free business, must be kept low. Okay, reason number two, the clients that come to you. I've done quite a bit of research on other people who've been part of the Ramsey Preferred Coach RPC program. And I will tell you that while some of these individuals are getting a number of leads, I've heard anywhere from 5 to 10 leads per month. The truth is, these clients are looking for Dave or somebody who's just like Dave. I'm not just like Dave. I'm not at all that sort of Papa Dave mentality. The way I handle things is very differently. And furthermore, these are not people who have found me on their own. They don't know my content. They don't know me. They don't have any opinion about whether or not I could be the right person to serve them. I guess what I'm ultimately saying is that they are not probably my ideal client, or very few of them are my ideal client. I know that my ideal client is a working professional or entrepreneur that's already earning a moderately good to very good income, and that they are struggling with the mechanics of having strong money management skills. And often those mechanics are disruptive, not because they can't figure it out or they're not smart enough, but because either A, they don't have the time to do the learning themselves and they need me to coach them and guide them through that, or B, they're dealing with emotional ramifications of experiences from a long time ago that they just need the handholding. The people that come in through the referral program could meet those criteria, but they could meet any number of other criteria that I'm not going to be very well suited to help them with. And I want to serve the people whom I can serve best. So item number two, or reason number two, is that I would be concerned that I would receive a lot of referrals, but few of them would meet my criteria for an ideal client. Number three reason is that the agreement would prohibit me from manipulating or modifying the Ramsey material that's provided to me as a referral partner. And if I'm part of the benefit of me paying $149 a month is being able to use the Ramsey materials, but I can't modify those materials to meet my specific needs so that I can coach clients in my words using my language so that there is a greater sense of, you know, trueness or authenticity in the delivery of that material, then that's a problem for me, because ultimately I would have to recreate everything on my own to have that branding. And so I don't know that having access to all of that material and paying for access to that material serves me. I would say that it doesn't serve me, because I'd have to redo all the work anyway, although it could trigger ideas. That being said, there is a slew of material online between Pinterest, other coaching sites that can trigger a tremendous number of ideas. And honestly, you can watch a lot of the free Ramsey material just to have idea generation for yourself as a coach, so that then you can produce your material. And reason number four, and this I think is actually the most important reason, is that The Ramsey Preferred Coach Agreement requires you to align and adhere strictly with the Ramsey approach to coaching. So that means 100% follow the baby steps and advise people to follow the baby steps in exactly that way. I have a playlist of ways that I disagree with Dave, and it doesn't even include all the ways that I disagree with Dave. I would feel really uncomfortable advising clients to only do it one way, which is the Dave way, when in my heart, I believe that for them in particular, given their unique circumstances, that another way would better serve them. This is the point of contention, the greatest point of contention that I have with the Ramsey Preferred Coaching Referral Program. And in the agreement, you are authorizing them to do quality control checks on you. So they will survey the people that they send to you that you coach. They will send those individual surveys to find out whether or not you're following Dave Ramsey's approach and whether or not the service was good, which means that they can then terminate that agreement at any time. So I understand why they would do that. It makes perfect sense to me. They are a business and they have a really beautifully branded approach. I mean, financial peace, come on. It's like iconic in the personal finance and coaching sphere. So I totally and perfectly understand why they would put this in the agreement. I just don't feel that it is right for me to agree to that, knowing that that then wouldn't be authentic and true to myself. And that right there, folks, is the most important umbrella reason that I want to give. You need to be authentic. You need to be genuine. As a coach, it is imperative that your integrity is held at the highest standard for yourself. People come to you and trust in you. And so you must be trustworthy. If you agree to do something, like let's say I went ahead and tried to be a part of the Ramsey Preferred Coaching Referral Program. Let's say I did that, but then I went ahead and coached in alignment with who I am. Then I have now created a schism in my integrity. I said I would do X, but I'm actually doing Y. This is just not something that I can tolerate in myself. And frankly, I don't think it should be tolerated in any coach. On the flip side, if you're a coach and you are 100% down for the baby steps, you have practiced Dave's approach and you love everything about it, then I think this referral program would be ideal for you because of a number of reasons. One, you already plan on doing it that way anyway. Two, you would get material sent to you that already has that branding on there, but that shouldn't dissuade you from using it since your entire program is grounded on his program. Three, you'd be having access to coaching forums where you can brainstorm and get guidance from other people who are following the exact same program as you. So I don't want to say that the Ramsey Preferred Coach is bad and not for anyone. I think it definitely has its target audience. And if you're in that audience, you should really consider pursuing it. For me, myself, however, I have decided that it would not be in proper alignment with the type of business I want to run and in full alignment with the feedback I am likely to give. So for those reasons, I have decided not to pursue the Ramsey Preferred Coaching Referral Program. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it's helpful to you. If it was, please hit the like button and the subscribe button, as I do plan on keeping this playlist going, and I would love to hear any comments you have. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.